If the screen is not clear, just let me know in the comments. If there is any issue with the audio video, let me know. All right, let's begin, guys. So how we are going to do is, first we are going to just mark a little bit of a horizon so that we know that this is where we want to, you know, end the Taj Mahal, so that we know where we are working. Horizon means a horizontal line. Just draw a rough line. I'm going to work directly with the pen. I'm not going to use a pencil, but whoever wants to use a pencil is free to use that. Okay, so just drawn a horizontal line and one more line a little bit above it, which is the platform. Same thing, you're going to draw a little bit of a horizontal line, keeping this light right now. We're not getting too much details. And at the end, okay, at the end of this, just take a little bit of a line here and make it straight. Say this is the center of the paper, okay? I'm considering that this is the center of the paper. If you are not comfortable with a pencil, you can mark the center of the paper. I'm not doing that. Or just in the top, you can just mark this, okay? So you have an idea that this is where the center of the paper is, right? So we're trying to keep it as symmetrical as possible. Doesn't mean that it has to be exactly symmetrical. A little bit here and there is, of course, fine. So we've got the platform down. Why are we making the platform first, guys? Because we don't know if we'll be able to do it right or wrong. So we don't want to get any errors inside, right? Now we are going to make our first structure. Okay, we are first going to work in this aspect. We are going to make the center structure. So can you see this much? We're going to be creating the top dome and this structure. So if you see, it looks like a rectangle. Can you see? This looks like a rectangle. We're going to be creating that rectangle first. Okay, say this is the top. Okay, and this is where you want to keep your top dome. Okay, so we're making a little bit of a straight rectangle. Work freehand, it will be more fun. Okay, if you'll want exact dimensions, you can of course also check out on my page. But otherwise, it's going to be more fun if you do it freehand. Okay, so we made one rectangle and we're just dividing it with a bar on the top. Any questions so far? This is what I marked is the midline. Here I made a rectangle, leaving enough space on the top for the top dome. I made the horizon. I made the area for the platform. Any questions, guys? If there are any comments, any questions, let me know so that I can at least understand. All right, I assume we're all good. Now, next to this, you're going to make another small line parallel to it, which is your first pillar. Okay, so one line here, one line here, and we're making a pillar here. You're going to slightly extend the pillar on the top and make a rounded kind of a structure, so it looks like a pole. Rounded structure and it looks like a pole, and a small pointed thing on it. So now it looks like the, you know, the typical mosque, or you know, this kind of a appearance. If you see, they'll have pillars on the top, or you know, domes on the top. And here we are going to make the first main dome, the primary dome. So make a semicircle. Okay, right? And on the top, basically, now once I remove the tape, I'll show you, is basically we are going to just get this kind of a structure here. This kind of a structure here. Right now I've kept the tape, so once I finish, I can just do that. Alright, so I'll wait. I'll again explain. We marked a horizon at approximately like 3/4 of the paper. After we marked the horizon, we drew a horizontal line. Then we drew a second horizontal line above it, which is indicative of this platform. Then we started by making a rectangle, so which is the center of the Taj Mahal, the main entry. Then we made two pillars around it, thin pillars, and we made the semicircle dome. Great. Was that difficult, or did you all understand that? Guys, just let me know in the comments so that I know what's happening. Alright, so we've not got any comments. I assume they're all okay. Kirtu said it's easy, great. Awesome. Okay, now in this dome, we'll just make another small semicircle here. A couple of lines, like you can make two or three lines. And then you're making, you know how you make in mandala, you make these scallops, just make these kind of scallops here. Alright? Easy? Made three lines and I made these scallops. Is it clear for everybody? I'm using a 0.3 micron. Okay. Anyone who did not understand this much? Alright, now I want you to pay a little attention. Where you have drawn this bar, a little bit below that, okay? You're going to draw one horizontal line that's maybe around 1.5 to 2 centimeters here. And the same line you're going to draw in the same line here, about 1.5 to 2 centimeters. So try to keep it equal on both the sides. This is two lines on both the sides. So what we have basically made is this, okay? This area we're making now. And we are going to be making one straight line that falls down. Right? So we've got one rectangle, second rectangle, third rectangle. A little bit of error is fine when you're doing an urban sketch freehand. It's completely okay to have multiple lines also seen. Right? Now from this point, okay, from this rectangle, same point, you're going to take one line which is slightly down. Okay? Almost equal or a little bit smaller. And then you're going to draw a second line like this. What we are doing, basically the Taj Mahal has multiple sides, right? So what you're seeing is the front side. So you're seeing the front and now this is the side area. Same thing you're going to do on the other side. Okay, if you need to extend this, please feel free to extend it. There is no right or wrong here. Any questions till here, guys? Anybody who's not understood till here? Alright, nobody can ask any questions, so I assume we are all good. Okay, so let's proceed. Once you've done this much, okay, we're going to be making a dome here. So how you do in this area, okay, on the top part, just draw another line parallel to this, another line parallel to this. Okay, we are making the top area. Awesome. I just need to ask so that we are on par or not par or whatever is happening, I come to know. Around this, make another pole. How we made a pole here? You're going to make one small pole here. Make a double line here. Make a small pole here. Okay? Easy for everybody? Making a pole here. Small, okay? These are small poles. Awesome. Is everybody following? Now, in this area, okay, only in this area, what you do is make a sort of a straight line and then a dome which is semicircle ending here. Straight line, semicircle. Same thing, straight line, semicircle. Okay. Again, on top here, you're going to just create some structure which is pointed and a circle. Pointed and a circle, okay. Cool. Now, where you drawn the semicircle, okay, you're going to draw another semicircle kind of a structure. This is a little bit one or two lines like this, and then some straight lines, one, two, maybe three, and you're going to put petals in between them. Petals as in, like, see how I'm making triangles, something like this. I'll repeat here, leaving some space. Again, two small semicircle lines and three vertical lines, or two or three vertical lines, and inside them petal 1, petal 2, petal 3. Great. Now here also you're going to make one small line on the side and a slight dome to it. Two poles. This is doesn't have to be very perfect. We just want to give the effect that the domes are in the front and they are there in the behind. Okay. So whatever you drew here, you're just trying to sort of replicate it. Good for everybody. Any questions? Awesome. Thank you. Okay, once everybody's finished this much, we'll make the pillars and then we start getting the details in, okay? Now leaving a little space on the side, okay? A little bit of space on the side. You basically imagine you're making a long triangle kind of a thing, but with breaks in between. So see this, one base here, then a break here. See how I'm drawing this? I'm going to use camel watercolors, basic watercolors today, nothing fancy. Okay, imagine this has to go up, okay? So continuing this line upwards, making this pillar, okay? Can you see how I'm making this pillar? One more time. This is a back pillar, so the back pillar has to look smaller than the front pillar. So can you see how it's growing smaller and smaller as I go from down to up? I am using PBH watercolor sheets. Okay, they have very nice handmade textured sheets which are very thick, and they are good, definitely going to be very good with absorbing water. The sketch is also coming out really well. I also have PBH Kolkata's brushes, synthetic art brushes, so I'm going to try those also. Right? And over here you're going to make a small structure with some lines and a dome on the top. That gives you your first pillar. You can't hear me? Can somebody just let me know if they can hear me? Okay, I'm using PBH Kolkata sheets. They are handmade watercolor sheets which are quite thick. They have 300 and 440 GSM also. And they are able to, definitely going to be able to take in a lot of water. So I'll show you all that also. Great. The life will be saved on Instagram unless it gives me an issue. The same pillar we are going to be making on the other side. Same distance, same height. Okay, from top to bottom, from bottom to top, making it smaller and smaller. Try and replicate the size as much as you can on both the sides. A little bit here and there, like I said, is not going to be much of an issue. I'll mention it in the caption once I finish it, okay? Can you hear me or you cannot hear me? Three people have written they can hear me, that is what I'm saying. Okay, so we are just making the pillar smaller and smaller as we go up. And as you reach the top, just make as if, you know, a three or four lines and a dome on the top. Thank you, Ankita. Right? So we've made two pillars, which are the back pillars. So as you can see the sketch, we have made this, we have made this. Okay, now we are going to make the front pillars. So once we finish all the sketch, then we come to the detail inside the Taj Mahal, okay? Same pillar that you made, you're going to make bigger versions here. So whatever is closer to you always looks bigger. Whatever is away from you looks smaller. Okay, if you need to extend the platform by any chance, please do it, okay? There's no problem. Whatever you think, it's not going to be seen anyways. It's just a rough platform. But see to that you have enough space on the side. Almost as if you have reached the first base till this height, you're going to make this thicker, bigger. Can you see this looks definitely bigger than this? Okay. Continuing it upwards, making it narrower. So you can see it almost looks like there's a continuous line. And you're just making these kind of bands over here in between, which looks like there's an architecture. Okay, there's just a structure. Okay, one more time, the same thing, we are doing three. Now I want you to see how it's looking like one line. You know, even if you draw it, it looks like one line. Right? And you see how it's making it smaller and smaller as I go up. Now on the top, again, just make two rectangle, like a rectangle, then a dome with a pointed tip. And here, you can just make the lines a little bit more distant from each other. Well, it is what my style is and what I have worked maximum to get into, so it should improve. The same IGTV is also there on my page where I have done everything with perfect measurements, and now I look at it and I realize that I would not work like that anymore. Now I work very freehand. So as an artist also you evolve, you know, with time. So like now I kind of work freehand only most of the times. All my illustrations will be most of the time freehand. How is it looking now? Is it looking like the Taj Mahal? Is it giving you the idea of the Taj Mahal now? Same thing, you're going to make another pillar here, leaving that kind of space. I want you to understand, see, even I am having multiple lines. When you're making a rough sketch, it doesn't matter if you're having multiple lines, it should just give you the resemblance. Hi, Anjali. Okay, so same pillar on the right side also. Okay, same pillar what we made on the right, on the left, we are making it on the right now. Again, same thing, narrow, top, bottom, wider. Then rectangle on the top. Oh, so you can probably tell me if it's looking like the Taj Mahal or it's not looking. I still have to see the Taj Mahal, not been to Agra. I'm from Mumbai. Okay, and a dome on this side. So now you can see it's looking very symmetrical. I've not used a ruler. It's completely done freehand. Questions? Anybody, any questions? Alright, now what we're going to do is we're going to finish this part and then we're going to come inside the Taj Mahal. Okay, so now where you have drawn your center line, imagine this is your center line, right? Around it, okay, wherever this pole is ending, just draw one line which is coming outwards, so this way. Can you see how I've drawn this? Because it's perspective, we have whatever is near us has to look broader, whatever is away from us has to look narrower. So same thing where this pole is ending, you can just make a sort of a line that's coming out diagonally. Hello Shivansh. And again on this side, the same thing, you're going to get two lines which are converging at the center point and diverging towards us. Awesome, so you can see how it's looking like it's coming out. And here we're going to draw these bushes or these random trees, okay, just very randomly. The biggest one being on the ones which are near us, and as you go towards the center, you're going to make them smaller and narrower, smaller and narrower. Okay, my screen is not clear. Is it clear now or still the same? Okay. Right, so just making these random bushes like some waves, nothing very detailed. From big to small. Okay, so where it's ending, that's the smallest. Okay, same thing here. You can make it in this direction also, small to big. Keeping a little bit of distance also if you want. It's not working. All good, okay. Okay, so just making these random bushes. And last one, maybe a little bit here. So you can see they're almost equal in the top area, but they keep sort of broadening and making a little bit bigger. So it looks like it's coming out. And you're going to draw these lines behind the plant so that it looks like it is going behind. And everywhere just make some vertical lines at some distance over here. regular intervals, just make these vertical lines. This is the platform, okay? We have not gone to the structure yet. Just made some vertical lines on the top, making some horizontal line to give it a little effect of the platform, okay? I'm using, yes, Sakura Micron 0.3. PBH Kolkata have sent, they've been very kind. They have sent me the materials to use. And I'm very excited to be using the paper. The quality of the paper is amazing. I'm excited to use the brushes also today. Okay, and just as if you're making some bushes kind of a structure here, just random shapes inside this, okay? In the pillars also. So basically there is a monument and there is architecture, but we are not drawing the architecture, we are just giving some random designs. Okay. Okay guys, so now we are going to start working inside the Taj Mahal, where we have drawn these top areas, okay. The top areas, you're just going to draw some sort of a horizontal line, some vertical lines, so it looks like a grill. Okay, both the sides, just some vertical and horizontal lines. Basically, the idea is to give that balcony kind of an effect. Same thing over here in the band area. See how I'm just making nice strokes, okay? Nice vertical strokes. And little bit of shading also you can do with your pen. I haven't got any questions, guys, so I'm going forward, okay? So if you'll have anything, let me know, because there are no questions coming, so I assume everybody's following. With the pen also, I'm giving a little bit of detail now, so you can get a little more effect with the pen. I'll show you that. See, making it a little darker and then just taking some strokes also. Okay, it's because it's going to be water here, I'm just making this kind of lines here. So even with the pen, you can get an effect of water. I'm waiting for people to catch up and ask me any questions before I start doing the main structure, because then I can't repeat that. Whoever wants to shade only with the pen can also shade like this if you don't want to get color in. Even that looks very nice, that looks like a sketch. I am an ink and watercolor artist. Okay, so basically I use pen and watercolors, that is my main forte. I also work with acrylics. These are the three things that I use. Okay, other mediums I do not use. Yes, they should be at 90 degrees approximately, so that it looks like they are standing. You can draw a line after watercolor also, but you will not get the same kind of effect. Awesome, so I'm just showing you all that with the pen also, I'm just getting a little shade inside. Now we'll make the center structure. Now leaving a little line on the side, you're going to draw a rectangle again. Okay, so a little bit line on the top, a little bit on the side, and you're going to draw one rectangle again. Okay, same way you're going to leave a little bit of space. We are not adding anybody. This is a live session where I am teaching. So unfortunately, I cannot add anybody. Okay, thank you. So I made a second area, like a second door. And in this, we are going to leave another line and make a third line. Okay, this might seem a little confusing. So I am just repeating this once we do this. Okay, I'll just repeat. we had made a bigger rectangle. We made 1, 2 and 3 smaller rectangles, okay? Now the middle rectangle which we have drawn, you're just going to draw some scribble lines inside it. Okay, so this looks like there is some carving in it. Just draw random scribbly lines, you don't need to get any detail inside. Okay, just random scribble lines. Now in this inner rectangle, the smaller rectangle, what you do is divide it into half and make a horizontal line here, so a bar like this. Not understanding, ask me, because I'm not getting any questions, so I'm proceeding forward, guys. I made three rectangles. The middle rectangle I've made scribble lines to give the effect of some sculpture. Then the inner rectangle, the smallest rectangle, I have divided into approximately two parts. The top part I am making another petal kind of a structure, and again giving some small squiggly lines here, so it looks like there is carving on this side. We are doing this right now. Okay, whoever can see the top reference, this is what we are working with. In the center again some, this is a petal, okay, this is just like a petal, how you draw a petal. One here, one here, one here, one here. Is it all okay? Yes, it's going to be saved unless Instagram gives me an issue, otherwise it's going to be saved. Okay. And I'm darkening this one. Last we are going to do is make one more smaller rectangle here. Okay, you don't have to make it exactly like I'm doing. Basically, you have to get the effect of the Taj Mahal. Thanks, Sharini. And a structure within that. And there is another door inside. So you can understand basically the amount of depth which is there that we want to show. The idea is, even if you don't get this exact depth, it's completely okay. Just try and focus on getting the basic shapes correct. Okay? So whatever is darkened, it means that it is depth. If there is more depth here, whatever is light means it is in the front and there is lesser depth there. Even with the pen, you can add shades by drawing some small strokes. You can add some designs here because there are pillars here also. See, what I'm trying to show you all is that it's possible even with a pen to get a lot of depth inside. Okay? Even on the dome, if I shade this much area, see, if I just shade this much and I shade on the side, can you see now the dome starts to look like it's convex? Guys, I'm not hearing from you all, so I don't know what's happening at your end. Here it's just the doorway, and here there is a monument pillar, but since my masking tape is here, you can't see it. Okay, I'll just put it somewhere here. Okay, just to get a dome appearance. In the dark petal there is a small doorway. Okay. You can add these shades with the pen also, so a little bit of texture comes in the pen. Okay, these are all effects that you can do with the pen. We will also work with the watercolor to get in more effects. Thank you, everybody. Here, make a longer rectangle here. Smaller rectangle on the top. Okay. Here you're going to make rectangles, but you're going to follow this outline, as in, you see this diagonal line. Why you follow this? Because it's on the side, right? So you cannot see the entire surface. It's blurred out, just give it 1 second, it will clear out. Same way, I'm making a window here and a longer window here. In all of them, same way, you can just make these petal kind of structures and give a little bit of shadow. Don't need to get any detail inside, just get some depth inside. Okay, you can make some structures or you can just give it a little bit of shadow, everything is fine. Okay, can draw some vertical horizontal lines. Nobody knows what is there. We don't are not getting the depth. We are just trying to get some effect inside. Thank you, thank you. Okay, again I'm repeating, don't need to get any details inside. You want to make, you can make, but otherwise it's just to get the effect inside. Hello Sanya. Okay. See how randomly I'm making these. Okay, again I'm saying there is no need for any particular details. The idea is to get the overall look of the Taj Mahal. You can even add a little shadow with the pen. So these pen strokes, you know, to get a little more depth inside. You can draw some vertical horizontal lines, you can make some door kind of a structure, whatever is okay. The idea is to just make it look like there's doors and windows, okay? Alright, can you all see? I'm just giving a little bit of details in between here and there. Same thing over here. I hope everybody is enjoying the live. Today it's a silent live. So,
sit down.
So I don't have the time honestly to collaborate. I just did a mega collaboration with 10 artists. I don't honestly have the time, but you can probably DM me later and we can talk on that, alright? So you can see even with the pen, the amount of look if the Taj Mahal is coming out so well. You can even add all these shades in the pillars.
I know that.
okay? So giving a little bit of more texture with the on the pillars as well. So see, your pen has to be very loose when you do this. The looser your pen is, the better strokes you'll get, the better effect you'll get. Is everybody following? Any questions? Right? We're done with the sketch in another 2 minutes. Same thing I'm doing on the left side. And then we do the watercolor, okay? Okay, somebody can let me know how the Taj Mahal is looking. Looking good, not looking good. Looking like the Taj Mahal or not. Is the live going okay? Just let me know. Thank you guys, thank you so much. Okay, so how much of a texture you want with the pen you can get in. We're starting to color in another minute. In case the live ends by in an hour, I might not restart it because the sketch is mainly done. If it does not end and we can finish the live, awesome. Okay. I'm Dr. Amay Parekh from the Thinking Palette. We just sketched the Taj Mahal. I think it's come out pretty decently. Awesome guys, so now let's begin with the coloring. So I'm starting with the top area, which is using cobalt blue. Okay, very light cobalt blue in the sky. Okay, I'm directly applying on the paper and slightly wetting the area and making lighter as we go down. Okay, this is only cobalt blue. And a very light color. Okay, it's a free illustration, so you can add colors as and when you feel like and how much you want to add. Okay, if you don't want to add color also, it's fine, or you just want to add color to the sky and let it be, that is also completely fine. Now just remember that you have to make it look like the sky. So all this is, you know, where the sky is seen. So you have to see to that you color according to it. So this gives the effect that you're seeing through the sky. All right. So you can see how the effect is coming out very nicely. How much you want to get in is up to you. The main thing was to get the sketch correct. Okay, so we've done that. I'm repeating, in case the live ends suddenly on its own by any chance, I might not restart it, but I'll mostly finish only before that. This is cobalt blue, no other color. Okay, some areas I make a little darker, some areas a little lighter. And you see how when it goes down, I'm sort of lightening it down, okay? I'm not keeping it very dark. Okay? I'm not going to be wasting too much time in just explaining all of this because I want you all to... What I wanted to teach you all basically was the ink illustration today that we've done. Now I'm taking a little bit of this gamboge hue and putting a little bit around in the lower side. Gamboge hue or chrome yellow, whatever color you have. And now I'm taking a little lemon yellow and just spreading it up, okay? So what this does, it basically gives you a nice halo kind of an effect around the Taj Mahal. So the Taj Mahal stands out so much more. Okay. Even in the soil area or the plant area, I'm just taking a little bit of sap green. And lemon yellow. And just getting a nice warm color, okay? This is lemon yellow and sap green. Okay, so this is looking quite bright now from what it was. Taking a little bit of this blue and putting it in the water area. So see how I'm moving my brush and the strokes. Leaving some spaces in between. This is also cobalt blue. Now taking viridian hue. Viridian green, and the trees I'm adding viridian green. The effect is basically that the grass is just blending into the trees, okay? You can take sap green, you can take any color, whatever you want. You can add combinations also. Sap green and viridian hue, okay? Sap green and viridian blue, combination of them. Okay, a little bit even in the grass, I can add a little color. Okay, a little bit of green I will even add in the water so it looks like there is reflection in the water. Now you can leave it at this also. If you want to add some more details, you want to add some more shadow to it, you can take little bit of black, a little bit of purple, whatever color you want, and you can just add a little bit of shadows everywhere. So I'll do that, taking little bit of diluted black Okay, see this now. So it's almost like a grayish kind of a tinge. Okay. I want you to see the result, okay? In just 2 minutes, we'll change the result. Taking little yellows, a little bit of blue. Just getting a little bit of color into the artwork. Not necessary. If you want to do it, do it. Don't want to do it, it's fine. But the idea is so that it doesn't look plain white and it looks like there is some color to it. Giving a little shadow here and there. Inside the Taj Mahal. Basically, we are giving depth to the painting, okay? I hope everybody is enjoying the session. Shadow with black, purple, blue, whatever you want to add. I'm using a little bit of diluted black. Okay. Just to get some depth in some areas, okay? You can add purples also, you can add a little bit of blues also. Like I'll add a little bit of blue also around here somewhere. How is the artwork looking, guys? So the brush is also really good. I'm really liking the way it's coming. Can somebody just let me know how is the artwork looking? Is it doing justice to the Taj Mahal? Tell your friends also to check out the IGTV. If you are recreated, remember to tag PBH Kolkata and tag me at the Thinking Palette. In case anybody is recreating it. That's our Taj Mahal watercolor illustration, ink and watercolor illustration. So I think it's come up pretty fair, guys. What do you say?